Now we always
rock. Also, I'm getting carried away. Carry on.
We always look at the old days of music with rose-tinted headphones on. Mm. That got into the top 30 of the charts. I mean, you wouldn't believe the kind of stuff that got in the charts in the old days, as we'll prove a little bit later.
Yeah. I know what you mean, though. Who'd have thought that a signature tune from a situation comedy? But I tell you what, you know, David Croft, co-writer and also director and producer and executive producer, he knew all the sort of tricks of the trade, and he said, do you know, this is so catchy. He said, I reckon we ought to, you know, release this as a single. So it just shows you're such a businessman. Not that he was, you know, absolutely in charge. I mean, he was the all-powerful man. But he knew what would appeal.
Yeah.
Fabulous.
I haven't even introduced the lady and she's off. The lovely, the one, the only, the unique Su Pollard is here.
Thank you, Dan. What a very, very nice introduction. Thank you. And of course, we were saying, weren't we, last time I was here?
Yeah.
Would it be about 8 years ago?
I think it was around then.
And that was another panto, that was Sleeping Beauty.
Yeah.
And I may as well give the plug, darling.
Yeah.
I'm here this year at the same place, Bournemouth Pavilion, playing wicked Queen Grimelda III. But my friends call me Grim.
You know. This is Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs, of course. I'm not going to say you get typecast, but you always seem to end up as the wicked queen. What's happening?
Well, because I'm too old to play principal girl or boy. And you can tell. In fact, the saddest thing, I think the final nail was when I was in Rill and I'd be principal boy, still managing to get away with it, 56, right, which is all right. But then sadly, my principal girl, she was about 18, I must have looked like, you know, Mrs. Methuselah. So I think I was moved on then by the producer saying, would you like to be the wicked queen next time? I think he was trying to break it to me gently that, Sue, too old.
But the dichotomy is, I've never met anyone that is more infectious, that makes you smile than you. How do you get into the bad part of the Queen?
Well, I know. Oh, no, you do. Because even though you're not necessarily like that yourself, you can draw on something like, oh, yeah, flipping annoyed me today, that man, or whatever. He probably hasn't done anything. Yeah. But then again, I think you've got to be very, very real. You know, I mean, I failed if I don't hear a child crying and being carried out in the first 5 minutes. I've failed in my task. And no, I think you just have to give it your all, and you can really pretend to be baddie if you got to be. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Let's get the exact date, 2nd to the 31st of December. It's Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs. Martin Dodd for UK Productions in association with the Bournemouth Pavilion. Mm-hmm. You need to go and find it on the website. Just search for Su Pollard Bournemouth and you'll be able to find the tickets. We'll give it a good old plug. When I said you were coming in today, we had more emails from people saying, Su Pollard, you're joking, not Su Pollard. I've got a great story about Su Pollard. Oh. I've already told you about my friend Sue, who took you on the back of some posh motorbike.
Oh, yes, I think it was a Goldwing job.
Goldwing job.
Looks like a semi-detached house by the time you're on it.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
Martin on the Isle of Wight says, Su Pollard, not just a comedy great, but a brilliant actress, saw in a Shakespearean play at the Yvonne Arnold Theatre in Guildford. Yeah. She even took her top off. That sort of thing stays with you. And Richard says, true story, I used to DJ at the Stag in Victoria before it got knocked down.
Yes.
It turned up one day and Su Pollard was in. I was chatting at the bar with her and she explained she was in menopause. I said, well, you're looking well on it. She said, no, it's the name of the theatre production I'm currently in.
Yeah. I remember this. I thought, oh, I'm going to stick in with this just to see what he says.
Yeah.
No, that was a fabulous pub. That was behind the Victoria Palace Theatre, which in turn is opposite the Victoria Station.
Yeah.
And it was a great place to go because it was obviously right by the theatre. All the theatre goers used to go in, and even if you were in a show there yourself, you always hot-footed it to the Stag, and then it became a venue for Above the Stag Theatre. There was a whole space above this pub, and the man was thrown to bits, the owner, because we said, look, can we use your space for a theatre? Oh, he said, yeah, because they'll all come here, you know, to the bar. And of course, but it became the first LGBTQ paid performers, you know, for all the gay shows. Oh, it was tremendous. So thankfully to the landlord, he actually started all that. So good on him.
Brilliant. Su Pollard, so if you've got any story about Sue from the dim and distant past or maybe the last couple of weeks, do let me know. It's steve@wave105.com on the WhatsApp 01489 481052.
Yes, I'm here with Steve. We're having a fantastic time. Gary, as we're speaking, is holding the video and very not wobbled once. So I think he's got a very steady hand. Anyway, I'm leaving now because part two is beginning shortly.
Do you remember who kept you off the top spot? I
well, I certainly do.
Yes.
She's not a fan anymore.
No,
she's lovely, actually. Dinah Ross. But, I mean, I did get beaten by a great song, Chain Reaction. I mean, I thought to myself, I was so excited because Bill as well, Bill Kimber, the record producer, rang me up and he said, we're number two this week. Wouldn't it be fabulous? I said, oh, it would be superb. I said, but look, you know, everything, you know, sometimes you get towards number one, aren't you? And you never know. But I mean, I was thrilled to bits to get that. But of course, it meant I had to go on Top of the Pops. Well, they said, oh, this is terrible. So we had to make a hurried release of a video. And I remember we had to go to Hampstead Heath, right? And with the snow, and there were the subjects of the documentary, you know, which was the theme tune starting together, The Marriage. And anyway, we didn't have enough crew, so I had to hold on to the, you know, the wires and the pipes while the cameraman was... I thought to myself, I can't believe this. Anyway, he said, what are we going to do? He said, look, just grab your jumper and shove it on your head like a turban. I said, well, this is not very, you know, it's a bit quick. He said, no, it'll be fine. I said, it's a bit impromptu. He said, no, it's marvellous. Anyway, so I put this tea cosy on my head. Well, I didn't, it was my jumper. And that was it. Not exactly sophisticated, Steve, but do you know, I must tell you, and people are so kind. Actually, I'm not a wedding singer per se, you know, but they always say, excuse me, could you come and sing at our Dean and Annette's wedding? There's no fee involved, but we can send you some wedding cake. So, do you know, you'd be surprised at the amount of wedding cake I've had. But there was one sad cake and it came in a jiffy bag and of course it got squashed in the franking machine. So it was Victoria's sponge, but it just came out as vunge because that was all I could eat. Oh, it was funny. You got to laugh.
People being in touch. Bernie's been in touch. So say hello to Sue for me. I drove her in Bournemouth Pride this year in a Bentley. We had such a laugh.
Yes, it was. Thank you, Bernie. Hope you're all right, darling.
Yeah.
It was really terrific. She was excellent. She knew the way. Well, I mean, I'm not saying she wouldn't, but, you know, it was marvellous. Yeah, it was great. No, it's the people that you work with that make a job good as well, you know.
Yeah.
That's the thing.
So, Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs coming to Bournemouth Pavilion from the 2nd to the 31st. That's a good old run, isn't it? Sometimes pantos are 2 weeks, but this is almost best part of a month.
Well, no, I think it is. And also, funnily enough, no matter how well rehearsed you are, you do need 3 or 4 performances to exactly know where, you know. But I think there's an exciting element to this panto this year. It's almost like AI, the mirror follows you around this time. It's very, very magical. And, it, you know, normally it can just be sort of like a framed a thing hanging from the fly floor, you know. But this one is... It's tremendous. I don't know who actually invented all this. And it's a new script this time. And there's lots of different surprises. It's the usual thing, the usual magic of it all, the wonderful LX and the sound that you get. So you've got all the traditional elements that people want to see, but equally there's lots of different things too. So I think people will have everything that they want to come and see. A story, the songs, the happy ending, the bits in between, the dwarves are fantastic. Yeah, so, no, we're all fabulous, I would say, everybody.
And most importantly, you get to see Su Pollard. Let's see what else is going on. Anne-Marie's at the Brighton Centre tonight, dancing in a winter wonderland with Alias and Jeanette at the Portsmouth Guildhall. Now, the number one panto this Christmas will be Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs at the Bournemouth Pavilion, and the star... Boo! Playing the role of Wicked Queen is Su Pollard. Boo!
Oh, that's pathetic. pathetic. Is that supposed to be a boo? Let me hear you.
Boo!
Yeah, that's what she said. Anyway, pathetic. Let's get down to business. Mirror, mirror on the wall. Who is the fairest of them all? You are, etc., etc. You know, and then we carry on. Oh, I love playing that part. It's marvellous. No, it's really good.
Listen, so many people have been in touch, and I will do these because they are just some lovely ones. Steve, my name is Jamie Riding. I have fond memories of lovely Sue. The first time I met her was last September when we were both at the same photo shoot working for the same panto company. She just brought in a ray of sunshine and was so kind to everyone. We've had many times that we've met since then, and I'm doing panto myself this year in Weymouth, and on my only day off, I'm coming to see Sue and her panto. It can be a tough industry, but with people like Sue, it makes it so much more brighter.
Oh, Jamie, how fabulous, darling, because I do remember, and were you, I'm sure it was Skegness, and I think I was Northwich, and we had a great time in this lovely, you know, because we all had to doll up in our frocks and everything and all that and make sure. No, and it was really lovely, actually. So, well, let me know. You come to the matinee all the evening, darling, but anyway, it doesn't matter. Just say, you know, you announce your arrival, and if we've got time between shows, we'll have a cup of tea. Allowed, of course, a glass of wine unless it's the evening one.
Okay.
But anyway, it'd be great to see you, babe, and have a great, great panto yourself.
Steve, love Sue. Please tell her I remember from when we lived in the same block of flats in Finsbury Park in the 80s. She was always so happy and kind. It was Alexandra National House. That's Maggie.
Yes, that was totally right. I remember that so much. I lived with my then boyfriend, Alistair. And the sad thing was, he was a lovely guy. He passed away. But when we split up, I think I got the real rough end of the deal because he had a fantastic car and I got the breadboard. So I don't know what happened there. Anyway, never mind.
David Romsey says, Steve, we met Su Pollard in a place called Oddbin's Wine Bar. Well, there's a surprise, isn't there? She breezed in Technicolor. Mum approached her, asked if she could sign Dad's birthday card, which she did. She wrote a lovely note in there for him. She is a lovely lady, really down to earth. So there you go. There's another one. Dave in Southampton says, love you so much, Sue. Every time I see or hear you, you make me smile ear to ear. Good on you, Cocker. We'll be booking to see you in Panto. Please stay. You know I always will. We'll never forget watching Heidi High with my parents. Thank you so much for all the memories.
Oh, bless him. What a lovely thing to say. It's the most marvellous thing to still always think that you've actually been involved in something that has been quite generational. Yeah. You know, we're talking about this, weren't we? That how lovely it is for memories, all of you in the one room. So it's my real pleasure, and I will never stop saying Heidi High, because people say, don't you get fed up? And said, why would I, darling? It's dissing people's memories if you don't remember that you're in it.
And do you know what? If you didn't have a tear in your eye for Peggy on the last episode, then you had a heart of stone. I think that was so beautifully written, wasn't it?
It was absolutely fabulous. And I couldn't believe it when he said, right, you're the last frame, Sue. No, I can't. Oh, and then there was one awful thing where we're all crying, good night, campers. But we had to do that early on. That was never filmed as the last scene because everybody had mascara. Even Paul Shane, bless him, and Jeff, who played Spike. It was the most heartbreaking thing. But tears of joy in a way, because we weren't going to do any more.
And performers like Paul Shane and Ruth Maddox, sadly, neither of them with us. They had so many more arrows to their bows, didn't they? But that they just, I don't know, was it a time and a place that Heidi High captured?
I'm sure it was. David always said he meant it to be the time when they had the sparsity and the sort of no camaraderie of the country, and they needed to get an injection of fun and laughter again after the war.
Yeah.
And I didn't know this because they obviously told us they got their experience from being redcoats.
Yeah.
And all the people, the characters that you saw on the screen, they were either a smaller or a larger version than all the people that they'd actually worked with, especially Yvonne and Barry Stewart. Oh, dear. Oh, they used to make me so laugh. And I loved it when one of the episodes, and Barry said, now, look, Yvonne, we can't have this. I mean, we're not being treated with the stature that we should. He said, I'm going to ring up the agent. And it just made me so laugh because the timing was fabulous. And he rang the agent and he said, hello, it's Barry. Barry Stewart Hargreaves, as if the agent didn't know. Oh, God, we laughed our heads off for 10 years.
Now, I don't know if it was the state of things to come, but my favourite character was the Punch and Judy man.
I absolutely agree. It's amazing. So many people loved him. And, of course, it was Leslie Dwyer.
Yes, that's
who,
it.
If you want to Google him, he was an amazing film star. Right, 40s, 50s, 60s, and still. But it was so funny because he went to live in Cornwall, obviously with his wife. And it's really funny because he said, I was in the supermarket the other day and these two young fellas came in and they went, oh, is that Punch and Judy man? Quick, come on, get out. Because you should say, didn't he? Sod off.
Yeah.
And he used to beat everybody up.
He was everyone's favourite drunk, wasn't he?
That's it. Oh, he was, and of course, he hardly ever drank, Leslie, really?
Did he?
No. He had about one drink as long as I'd known him for 10 years,
wow.
Practically. It was amazing. Oh, can I do a. This is my. This was my remembrance thing.
Yeah.
But
now, we brought this in specially for you, Sue. So,
but,
here we go.
I'm so sorry, in the musicians amongst you, I'm afraid I don't know my E-flat from my B minor. I'm so sorry. I'm sorry about that, Ruthie.
Yeah.
Wherever you are up there, darling, I do apologise. Naff.
Sue Pollard's here. We'll talk some more in a moment. Sue Pollard's here. That's the harmonica. That was. Now, have we decided, is it a glockenspiel or a xylophone? What do you reckon, Sue? Is that...
Yes, metal is a glockenspiel.
Yes.
And, of course, the xylophone is the wooden one.
And we've got to thank Vanessa and all at Alverstoke Infant School who have lent us that this afternoon. They'll never play it again because it's been touched by Sue Pollard.
Bless you. Thank you so much for organising that. Really appreciate it a lot. Because, honestly, when I was on a plane with Ruthie, of course, who was played Gladys, it was amazing. We had to go inside when you were allowed to, in the cockpit. And she played the thing and she'd go, Heidi, hi. Then I'd have to go, oh, Miss Cathcart's coming quick. What you have to do? I wonder if Lord Cameron has to do that kind of thing when he's on a plane.
Did it get you an upgrade?
Oh, actually, we were already upgraded because they used to like us.
Sorry.
And say, oh, come in. Sorry about that.
Sue is here because she is the star playing the role of Wicked Queen in Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs coming to the Bournemouth Pavilion 2nd to the 31st of December. If just hearing Sue this afternoon hasn't you encouraged you to buy tickets, I don't know what will. Caroline on the island has been in touch, as many of you has. She says, oh, Sue, what a tremendous, beautiful breath of fresh air. Just love her. So there you go.
Well, I'm sure, I wonder if that's Caroline, you see. Another friend of mine called Caroline.
Yes.
She's a costume designer and maker. And of course, she was born on the Isle of Wight. Now, she always calls it the island. So it might be that Caroline. But if it's not, thank you anyway, Caroline, the other one. Bless you.
So, Panto endures like never before. It continues to evolve. You continue to light up the stages.
Oh, bless you. Well, I always like to think that there's nothing better than live work because the audience react that day. If you do TV, it might not be on for 6 months because of the scheduling. So you never know what the reaction's going to be. But there, and I can promise you, I always call it this VFM, which means value for money.
Yeah.
And, well, this is what this station is, except it doesn't say V, it just says FM. Wave value for money. Well, it's been fabulous.
Talking to telly as well, can I just give a big plug as well? If you haven't looked at it, it's a brilliant series. Selena loves it. Pilgrimage, The Road Through Portugal, which has been on, which you were in, weren't you, with others. Well worth a look at that. Quite thought-provoking. And one of those kind of, what I politely call a reality show, that's just got a bit more to it than eating... kangaroo.
Well, yes, exactly. It was a tremendous, you never know what you were going.
No.
Of course, you were given the heads up about what you were expected to do, where you had to go and all this. But it was the most amazing thing because we actually went to Fatima. You know, that was one of the pilgrimage. And, well, my dear, all those thousands of people in that square with their candles and whatever religion you were, well, you can't fail to be moved. We all cried. And, well, there's nothing wrong with a bit of heart showing a bit of soul that you've got in you. It's marvellous.
Su Pollard, Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs at Bournemouth Pavilion, 2nd to the 31st of December.
Can I just say one more thing?
Yes.
Yes, yes. And don't be fooled by my persona. I'm going to get you.
Break a leg.
Yeah, thank you.